Yo. And hello out there to everybody. I'm going to revert back to the assembly. Nearly stuffed up. The new rockets I put on aren't going to fire in the right place. And we have liftoff. And for today, I'm going to see if I can put this into a nice orbit, do a couple of science experiments, and bring it back into the planet. Bring these little guys back. You see the little facial expressions, aren't they cute? And so far, successful liftoff. First stage gone. it's starting to get a bit of a trajectory, so we can put in a maneuver. For a bit, realign ourselves. Get lined up with this blue marker. T-minus. Alright, we got 13, 12, we got a dual burn of 16 seconds, so I want to kick this off at 8 seconds. Pretty low there, though. There you go, 160. So we'll pull one more maneuver off, so we'll get us to that right altitude. We've got 11 minutes, so we'll do a bit of a fast time. And that'll work. All right, now orbiting. We can freely go about our days. I'll make sure I'm in prograde. Means that the nose is facing the way that we're moving. Roll us upright as well. Oh, sorry, I'm speaking in the wrong one. Alrighty, now we're going to do some surface scanning as well. I'm too high at the moment, but as we come in, we'll do the surface scan. I've got atmospheric spectrometer, two of, solar panels are charged, everything up. All right. Here we go, re-entry. Fingers crossed it builds the rocket off without doing any damage to my astronauts. Coming in pretty hot. Add some reverse thrust. And we're out of monopole. See how it goes. Nearly through it. 20,000 meters. There we go. Cooling down. Down a bit more. Oh crap. That was a catastrophic failure. All right, I gotta fix a couple of things. Try this again. Alrighty. Activate SAS. Yeah, 5, 4, 3. Pray to fucking God. Let's do it. to get to at least 600 meters a second before we detach to the second deployment, and then put it into an angle. So, I'm gonna coast for a bit. burns, when it gives you a burn time, you want to halve that, and then you want to start the burn at that half with how much you got left. So T minus whatever the half is. The computers sort of already figure that you're accelerating, so you've got to compensate it in a few areas. You can see here the circle, the blue one starting to match the delta one, which is what my intended path. You keep bringing it in, and get ready for shutdown in around about 30 seconds. Settle for that one now, because the gimbal moved, I didn't notice it. Alright, we're going to save what fuel we have for the trip back in. Get some charge back in the battery. Alright, these boys have done a few laps. Alright, so you can see I've got a 21 second burn, so I want to kick it off at around about 10-11 seconds. Alright, there's my re-entry. So now, we've got to chill out and wait. So, we'll get him to face retro. So that means my arse end and heat shield will be facing that. go, re-entry. Arm the chutes, so they should deploy at the right times now. I remembered. Uh-oh. That's bad. That's bad. That's bad. That's also bad. Parachute's still on. Alright, so I had a few modules blow up, but the astronauts survived. Yep, in the water. Let's see what you get. Got a few space points, yee-haw. Alright, so flaws. Apart from it blowing up on me. Thank you. All right, new rocket. Let's see what we can do here. We got some points I can spend. Streamline this puppy. Maybe we won't be going streamlined for now. Still gonna be going with the old cylinder. Gonna unlock some more parts, I think. So we'll go with that. Gotta upgrade the launch pad. crossed, it's not the last ride. Orientation to face east-west, so I can just tilt backwards on the stick. Alright, let's give this a whack. Alright, full throttle. Astronauts look prepared. Yes. Let's do it. No, a bit of instability in the rockets there. Done a bit more supports up around here. Held true though. Getting some good altitude. Some of your boosters are burning nicely. Rip off the side of the spaceship, I'll be happy. Hey, Squiddy. Probably wondering what I'm up to, aren't you? Yeah, playing Kerbal Space Program. Literally got my little pilots down here. Got my spaceship, which is in currently final stage, doing some experiments while I'm orbiting the planet. Yeah, pretty much you gotta set your orbits and everything else. It's not just for planet Earth, the planet either. It's got the moon. And you got a couple other planets further out. And you got that star. And then eventually when you get brave and bold enough, you can actually leave the star system. It's all proper. Yeah, it's absolutely brilliant game. I love it. It's full on. Really high-end engineering aspect. Then you got the little characters down here. They got funny faces on them right now because they're all excited. It's a pretty cool mission. Oh, I've been on this for a couple of hours, and this is the second launch I've done where it's sort of been successful. If you rewatch this later on, you'll see my first one, I sort of blew up. It was a total failure. And I had to build the rockets from scratch as well. Well, I'll put it to you this way. There's a fellow who's worked for the engineering division in NASA itself, and he says that you learn more playing this in a day, well, in 100 hours, than you do doing a 5-year aeronautical course. So, frankly, yeah. You gotta understand, it teaches you a lot of things. Yeah, the aerodynamics, the physics at work, plotting and setting orbits, trajectories and stuff like that, interceptions for other orbital bodies, being able to get your spacecraft to be captured by, say, the moon or another planet. I mean, when I first tried this game out a couple of days ago, I lost an astronaut to the sun. He's currently orbiting the sun. So yeah, currently at the moment, just letting these guys do a few orbits. Because they've got a research module, one of these bigger ones here. And it's getting me some science points at the moment. There we go, we got a time warp. Six days, let's see what we're up. 23 science points. Yeah, I reckon 6 days in space for these boys right now. I mean, they haven't even got proper living quarters or space, so I think, yeah. Although they do look pretty happy at the moment. These are the guys in the back. Alright, let's shut everything up. Alright, everything tucked away, we're ready. Alright, now to plot a re-entry orbit. Add a maneuver there. Retro burn, that'll do it. Only requires 17 seconds. Happen in 3 minutes. Oh crap. I've got to put a coupling on to separate my monopellant tanks. And I gotta fix me nozzles up. let's see what survives and doesn't survive. Boom, boom, kaboom. That coupling there should have separated. I think I had it set up wrong. Go 40k out. The heat's starting to build up in a few places. Primarily, we've got things sort of in check. This is not good. Go on top of this hole here. Nothing blew up this time. Except I think I'm still a bit too heavy because I've still got rockets on. Let's see how we go. No, we're all going straight in. I gotta fix these things. Oops. Being too greedy. Thank you. All right, homeward bound trip. Frankly, I don't want to be carrying all this fuel, so I can get rid of this. Gotta go face prograde though.
A new follower.
Hell yeah!
Hey Caden, thanks for the follow, mate. Just coming back in to... Kerbal, I think it is they call it. Got an orbit plan all set up. So right now, I've got my blue line here, and it's going to intersect with the planet. Just going to keep my ass end point, and I've let my last of my two boosters go there. They're on their way back to the planet's surface. Let's see how we go here. Already at 180 odd kilometers up at the moment and falling. We'll speed up time a bit. Let's see how we go in. You should see start burning up shortly. Sucks though, the time physics sort of mess around with the game physics, so you have to bring it back to normal for it to catch up. Alright. And I think I'm all out of propellant. Here we go. We can either blow up or survive. Oh yeah, this is gonna hurt. It's gonna go in like a bullet. or it's going to spin itself apart. Got no RCS left, no fuel. I don't know why they're smiling. They're all about to die. Let's see if we can flip it back around. Here we go, the burn up. Maybe transferring the heat from one side to the other might help. Keep this going though, or else my chutes won't deploy if the nose is pointing down to the ground. I can't see the planet surface because it's not tight. Oh! That was a module explode. This is not going to go well. Two solar panels. Let's see how well they made these capsules. Too bad, because we're pretty level with the horizon at the moment. So if we keep sinking at this sort of rate in a balanced state, chutes should be able to deploy. So not only got these guys in the cockpit, but I've also got these guys in the back. Still going like a bat out of hell. Still going nose into the ground. Can't apply any roll. Chutes are not going to deploy. My crew is going to die. Oh! Untangle, untangle, untangle. Oh, the crew didn't die. Oh, oh yeah. Alright, speed up time, get him to the ground. Lose there. I lost a fair few things. All right, let's see what we got for it. We only got 9.5 science after all that shit blowing up. Yay. Give me the money back at least. And crew got some EXP. What do I need? Air brakes. Everybody needs air brakes.
Oh, buddy's getting low.
Oh, that was a yawn from me. Alright people, I'm gonna head off. Thanks for joining me for this. That was a fun little new game to try out. Hope to see you all next time.